Biology with Risa. Review videos, chi-square test, and genetic crosses.
A chi-square test is a statistical test that can be used to see if observed values for a set of data are similar to or significantly different from expected values for that same set of data. Statistical tests are necessary because rarely do our observations match perfectly with our expectations. This discrepancy may be due to things such as random variation or experimental errors. Statistical tests, like the chi-square test, are important when observing the inheritance of specific traits because these statistical tests help us to determine if the specific traits we are interested in are inherited using simple Mendelian patterns of inheritance or something more complex is going on. Gregor Mendel actually used chi-square statistical tests to demonstrate that he could predict the phenotypic ratio of offspring. Let's imagine we are Gregor Mendel, and we are investigating the seed shape of pea plants. We think round seeds are caused by a dominant allele, and wrinkled seeds are caused by a recessive allele. We cross two plants that are heterozygous for seed shape. Then we count the number of round seeds and wrinkled seeds in the offspring of that cross. Let's say we counted 5,474 round seeds and 1,850 wrinkled seeds in the offspring. These counts would be our observed values because they are the actual numbers that we saw, or in other words, observed. Now, the question is, are these observed values similar to, or are they different from what we would have expected to see from a cross between two heterozygous individuals? In order to answer this question, we can just do a simple chi-square test. The first step in doing a chi-square test is to determine how many offspring we expected to see with each phenotype. You already know how to do this. You simply use a Punnett square. Remember, Punnett squares allow us to determine the probability that a certain phenotype will occur in the offspring. Therefore, it can tell us the values we expect to see. Let's do a Punnett square for the two heterozygous parents in our example. From this Punnett square, we can see that we would expect 3/4, or in other words, 75% of the offspring to be round, and we would expect 1/4, or 25% of our offspring to be wrinkled. The total number of offspring we observed was 7,324. So how many of these 7,324 offspring did we expect to be round? How many did we expect to be wrinkled? Well, you just simply take the total number of offspring and multiply that by the proportion you expected to see. Since we expected 75% of them to be round, 7,324 times 0.75 equals 5,493. How many did we expect to be wrinkled? This time, you just take the total number of offspring and multiply that by 0.25. 7,324 times 0.25 equals 1,831. After you have found the expected values, then you just fill out the rest of the table. First, I would take each observed value and subtract that from the expected value. 5,474 minus 5,493 equals negative 19. 1,850 minus 1,831 equals 19. Then you take negative 19 and you square that, and that gives you 361. Remember, when you square a negative number, it gives you a positive number. So by squaring it, we're pretty much just getting rid of any negatives present. You will also take the 19 from the second row, square that, and that equals 361. Then you take the last number you calculated and divide that by the expected value for that row. So for the first row, we would take 361, divide that by 5,493, and that would equal 0.066. And for the last row, we would take 361 and divide that by 1,831, and that would equal 0.197. Then to calculate the chi-square value, which we will need to find our p-value later on, we simply sum the last column of our table. 0.066 plus 0.197 equals 0.263. So 0.263 is our chi-square value. Now we can't stop here. Next, we have to find our p-value. You will use the chi-square value you just calculated to find the p-value in a table. The p-value is always a number between 0 and 1. The p-value is necessary because it tells us whether or not there's a difference between our observed and our expected values. So we need this p-value to do the statistical test. Only if the p-value is very small, so less than 0.05, do we say that there's a difference between the observed and expected values. If the p-value is greater than 0.05, then there is no significant difference between what was observed and what was expected. So only a small p-value, again, will tell us that there is a difference. Now let's find our p-value using the chi-square table shown here. The top row of the table always lists the p-values. Notice they get smaller as you go to the right. The rest of the values are the chi-square values associated with each p-value. In order to find where our chi-square value falls, we have to look at the correct row. Each row represents a different degree of freedom. The degree of freedom is simply the number of categories in our data set minus 1. Since we only have 2 categories in our data set, our categories again are round seeds and wrinkled seeds, our degree of freedom would be 2 minus 1, which is 1. So our degree of freedom is 1, and we would only be focusing on row 1 of the table, and we could ignore the rest of the table. If we were, for example, looking at 4 different phenotypes and had 4 different categories, then we would be looking at row 3 and so forth. Remember that the chi-square value we calculated was 0.263. Where does that fall along row 1?
A chi-square of 0.263 would fall right here, between 0.15 and 0.46. Therefore, if we look at the top row, which represents our p-values, our p-value would fall between 0.5 and 0.7. Therefore, we would conclude that our p-value is greater than 0.5 and less than 0.7. Since our p-value is greater than 0.05, we would conclude that there is no significant difference between the observed values and the expected values.
Below is a summary of the steps you need to follow when doing a chi-square test. First, you need to record the observed values. Then you have to find the expected values using a Punnett square. Remember, you will multiply the probabilities you get using the Punnett square by the total number of observed offspring in order to get those expected values. Third, you're going to calculate the chi-square value by filling out the table. Then you will use a chi-square table and your degrees of freedom, which equals the number of categories minus 1, to find the range where your p-value falls. And then finally, you will make a conclusion based on that p-value that you found.
If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to see more biology videos.